Song, I Can Be Great.
Everything's in line, but I'm So need a voice actor. Need a light to take me home. I kinda need a hero. Whenever I see the forest full of trees, I can really hear some melody. Baby, I'm a little blind. I think it's time for you to find me.
Somebody speak to me, 'cause I'm feeling like hell. Need you to answer me, I'm overwhelmed. I need a voice echo, I need a light to see.
I'll tell you when I say three,
home.
Jump, okay?
I need a star to follow.
One.
You to find me. Can you be my lady? Say.
What are you gonna do, Mary Poppins?
You took the phone.
Oh, you look great, Mary Poppins. Amazing. Okay, can you say supercalifragilisticexpialidocious?
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Can you say just a spoonful of sugar? Thank you, Mary.
Go very well.
Wanted a nanny for two adorable children.
Adorable? Well, that's debatable, I must say.
If you want this choice position, have a cheery disposition.
Jane, I don't...
Rosy cheeks, no warts.
That's the part I put in.
Play games, all sorts. You must be kind, you must be witty. Very sweet and fairly pretty.
But of all the ridiculous...
George, take us on outings, give us treats. Sing songs, bring sweets. Never be cross or cruel. Never give us castor oil or glue. Love us as a son and daughter. And never smell of barley water.
I put that in too.
If you won't scold and dominate us, we will never give you cause to hate us. We won't hide your spectacles so you can't see. Put toots in your bed or pepper in your tea. Hurry, Nanny, many thanks, sincerely, Jane and Michael, thanks.
In every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. You find the fun, and snap, the job's a game. And every task you undertake becomes a piece of cake, a lark, a spree. It's very clear to see that a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way. A robin feathering his nest has very little time to rest while gathering his bits of twine and twig. Though quite intent in his pursuit, he has a merry tune to toot. He knows a song will move the job along. Sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way. The honey bees that fetch the nectar from the flowers to the comb never tire of ever buzzing to and fro, because they take a little nip from every flower that they sip. And hence, they find their task is not a
Kitty.
Go.
Manish, manish.
No. Manish.
Manish.
Ha. Chepe.
Hola, Leilo.
Ah, no. Oh. Ha.
Me.
Un.
Ma. Ha. Ha. Me.
Ha.
Me. Bu. Ma. Ha.
Ha. Laila. Ha.
You went out to
baby. Ha. Laila.
You went out.
Cool. Say, I love you.
Love you.
Who are you talking to?
Uncle David.
Days, seeing those new faces, don't know what to say.
first stop. And when we get off the bus, I'll say hello properly. We'll talk about what we're going to do today. It's a beautiful day. Hopefully, see and learn about interesting things. Think about the country a little bit differently. Becoming experts on security. Step, I can speak 30 to 40 minutes, so bring a little bit of water if you want to have a day, like just a tiny walk to a nice place to sit down, hopefully shaded. There's a toilet here which is normally open. I think there's just one, maybe two cubicles, so if you need it, use it and then catch up, or use it when we come back to the bus. The bus is going to stay in the same place.
Ramona, can you wave hello? Did I do it?
Yeah.
In walking position.
Seasons come and seasons go.
What a big girl. What a big girl. What a big, big, big girl.
Yummy.
Let me hold you, darling, so you won't cry.
Are you enjoying your car? I feel so yummy.
Thank you.
תגידי שלום.
עוד תגידי.
Yeah, I gotta show it to my parents, you know?
Give me a memory.
this old piano. I ought to capture the moment this morning I'm too lonely. We are gathered here to get through this thing that we call life. Come on, boys.
Yeah.
Children, and you remember the last time you saw her was before she even had the first one.
No, that's not true.
No? Rivka, she said.
When I saw her, she had at least one child.
Oh. So I know that.
I think so.
But, like, when you think of years and years of children,
yes,
like, their ages,
yeah,
it's pretty crazy.
It's very
This is making me think of Star Wars.
I'm going into the Death Star. Look at that bridge.
Ooh. We saw that from up there.
That's scary.
The sun is so big here.
Wow. That's crazy tall.
And in my video, you see the sun. And I'm gonna, when I show you the video, you're not going to believe how big the sun is. I feel like we're closer to the sun here. No, I'm serious. I had that moment when I got off the plane and I was like, wait, the sun is, like, actually, the diameter looks larger.
I've so enjoyed driving around Israel. That's so special.
So
it's a different Israel when you can drive.
Yeah, it's what's that pasuk been like? Walk amongst it and make it yours, or something like that.
Yeah.
With Abraham, his mission. It just doesn't get old.
Going down the mountain.
Woo!
Look at that bridge. You get that in your video?
The bridge ahead of us?
Wow.
Yes. It's really fun to use my new camera. This is a really fun film.
You need to make sure you share all your videos with your community so you can make sure I dig it into the movie.
Yes. Have you been collecting the pictures that I've sent you?
If you send them to me on WhatsApp, I get them automatically.
Awesome. So, you've been my backup this year. My insurance policy.
Yeah.
In case I lost my phone or something like that.
Yeah.
Which I did.
Yeah.
So I'm glad that I sent you guys pictures as much as I did. I wish I did more videos. I'll just have to live here forever then.
Any of your Tivolim or trips around Israel, have you seen the Roman aqueducts?
I don't believe so.
So, it's amazing. The Romans would bring water across the entire country with these bridges that just held water. And what was amazing about their engineering is they knew how to gradually lower the slope, but so gradually that if they did it too much, the water would get stagnant, it would stop in place. So they had to always be lowering it just so incrementally. To bring it from like Tel Aviv to Jerusalem, like that distance, it's just amazing what they used to do.
Yeah, I'm continuously amazed by
engineering. And many of them are still working.
Really?
Yeah. They did it all over Europe too. It's really cool in Israel.
Yeah.
Usually you'll see them on the side of the mountain.
Part of the thing of like growing up in the U.S., right? It's like such a young place in terms of its history.
Yeah.
That like I was talking to my friends from the U.K. and stuff, and they were telling me that, like, if you dig in your backyard,
yeah,
you may find like coins from like the Roman period or like.
Yeah. Not in the U.S.
So it's like, to me, it's such a novel thing that this is such a historically rich place.
Oh, yeah.
But apparently just the old world, that's just like...
Oh.
And I think I'm...
No less cool, though.
No less cool to me.
Right.
I think it's neat.
I think it's really neat, too.
I like history.
That's one of those things, like, I think in a different life...
Historian?
Hmm?
Historian.
No, an archaeologist.
Oh, fascinating. I'm dubious of archaeology.
What do you mean?
Meaning, it was put to me one way, one time, that like, if like in a million years from now someone finds your home, they say, this must have been the most important room in the house. Because there's a chair.
Right.
And it's all white, which symbolizes the gentry. And then it's your bathroom.
Yeah. It is certainly subject to interpretation. I had the same kind of difficulty when I took some archaeology classes where they would say, based on a certain design in the pottery, they knew what time and period came from.
Right.
And I'm thinking to myself, I draw things differently every time.
Yeah.
Right, so was it that particular style? Was it only style that they would do at that particular time? And if you deviated from that style, you were ostracized. I mean, how could they know that?
I guess maybe it was, like, fashion, that, like, our fashion changes each season, and sometimes we're constantly recreating ourselves, but also, like, you recreate within a framework, meaning, for example, it's, like, how our bitch knew how to go through Psukim, right? When we were learning Kohat, when we were learning Eov, we would read it, and then we would interpret it, and then we would ask questions, and then we would come up with interpretations,
right.
And only then would we look in the Mefarshim,
right.
And it changed my view on Chidush, because... We came up with ideas, but they were all the ideas that were presented in the Midrash.
Interesting.
I mean, Farshim. Is it a Chidush?
I hear you. I understand the issue.
So same with this patterns.
Yeah. I tell you something else with the patterns. Like, you know that sometimes nostalgia kicks in, even with fashion. People start wearing
Greco
things that they used to wear. They'll wear things that they used to wear 30 years ago, because it's like, ooh, let's wear it, because it's nostalgic.
Yeah.
So same with patterns on, like, pottery. Maybe they started doing that pattern because it reminded them of what they used to do 100 years earlier.
Right.
How do you know if it's really from 100 years earlier or something that they were doing nostalgically? I don't know.
Exactly.
So that stuff, I always had a problem with.
I guess carbon dating gives you 8 years.
I was going to say carbon dating, I have much more confidence in. But the truth of the matter is that the kind of archaeology that I like is less about, I mean, things like pottery shards is really about trying to get very specific about dating an era and how they lived their lives. I really like things like the structures more.
Like the architecture through that?
Architecture, yeah.
Yeah, it's fascinating.
Yeah.
Though I am a sucker for when they find, like, the what could be the Rimon of the Kohen Gadol.
Yeah, that's neat stuff.
In the old city. Or when they find stuff like, this is by Rishon. Like.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, it's a shame. We should have gone to Ramat Rachel next time.
For what?
To show you that they have an archaeological site dating back to Bayit Rishon, and it's one of the only ones. So you went there with your brown one Shabbat.
What did you see there?
We saw one of their homes. It was a home they found. And the question was, which mountain it is. Because before they planted the trees there, you got a full view of all the surrounding area. And, like, he thinks it's, like, the most sad thing that they planted trees because it got rid of, like, the view. Like, I can't place right now which mountain Tanakh it was. Do you see your Rouge Puppet?
Yes. What was it about? What did they find that helped them know that it was from the biracial period?
It's a great question. I do not recall the answer, but I hope to go back so I can take pictures of the plaques and then we can go over it together. Yeah. So, the Bible Lands Museum is fascinating. It made me want to learn Akkadian. And I was like, they teach us ancient Hebrew, why don't they teach us ancient Akkadian? Give us a well-rounded education, because it's all come from the same era. But
I'm partial to Ugaritic myself.
Ugaritic? Isn't Akkadian the written language of Ugaritic?
I have no idea.
I was telling you that the Tamani guy in his school, like, is learning Akkadian. Or something like that. Or was it Ugaritic? I can't recall.
Driving down.
It must be very freeing to be on a motorcycle on such a smooth road.
Yep. I will tell you, these roads are in really good condition. That's also true.
Yeah, it's going to be so hard to go back to New York.
Oh. It's a very green forest.
We're very close to Lod. We see the forests. Is that a forest?
Those are forests. Those are man-planted forests.
I never thought about Israel having forests. I just thought it was flat plains.
JNF is planted with trees all over Israel. Totally reforested.
Zakaria, right?
What's
Zakaria? There was a Navi that said, like, part of the Nebuah he said, like, there will be the children's playing.
That I know. I don't remember.
There also trees. Might not be Zakaria. I see a sign for Lod and Beit Sheva.
6.7
miles. Ben Gurion. We try to stay as far away from Ben Gurion Airport as possible.
Everybody loves the things you do, from the way you talk to the way you move. Everybody here is watching you, 'cause you feel like home. You're like a dream come true. But if by chance you're here alone, can I have a moment before I go?
Cause I'm by myself all night. Oh, it's more like you're on a runway. Go back over there, wave it.
Times we had, I hope you smile and know that through the good and through the bad, I was on your side when nobody could hold us down. We claimed the bride. star, and we came so far, and no, they won't forget. Yeah. Whenever you remember times gone by, remember how we held our heads so high when all this world was there for us, and we believed that we could touch the sky. Whenever you remember, I'll be there. Remember how we reached that dream together. Whenever you remember, when you think back on all we've done, I hope you're proud. When you look back and see how far we've come, it was our time.